So it is Friday. It is fun day. And I have been working for 2 days to get this story onto this show because I think it is one of the best company blog posts I have ever read. Essentially, Moxie Marlin Spike, the founder of Signal, which recently integrated some parts of micro crypto payments on the platform, narked on the narcs. He posted a blog post in which he sort of deconstructed and hacked Cellebrite, which is a firm that basically uses software and physical tools to hack into cell phones and extract data from them. They're kind of a notorious company. They work with, you know, governments, they work with law enforcement, they work with whoever will pay them, basically. And this was an instance in which he said, okay, I found this, you know, this hardware, I've taking a look at the software and hacked in and found that it was rife with its own sort of security vulnerabilities. Now, there are all sorts of fun things that can be pulled out of this one, but Naomi, I'll toss this to you first, then we can dive into it. Or Zach, get in
here. I have a question.
Was the part about it falling off a truck, well, that was a joke, right? Or was that real?
There's been no confirmation.
I've been thinking about that so much.
First, tell us about it. Truly unbelievable. You can also buy these things on eBay.
Okay, cool. So he just like got it and then like took a picture in the street, right? That's what happened?
I cannot say. I want to know that part.
That part was so like
the origin story
or something. I couldn't quite figure it out. But anyway, Naomi, take it away. Sorry.
Well, I think that's the first thing to dive into is that this article is so tongue-in-cheek and hilarious, and I love Moxie for it. So he phrases it by a truly unbelievable coincidence. I was recently out for a walk when I saw a small package fall off the back of a truck ahead of me. It just happens to be one of these analytics tools that said that they've just opened up services for Signal, which is the private messaging service that Moxie runs, is the CEO for. So it is a truly unbelievable coincidence. So, of course, he dived into this package, figured out how it works, realized they had all kinds of their own vulnerabilities. So the crux of this story is that he figured out how to hack the hackers, right? You know, if you have a phone and someone is trying to intercept it and figure out what's going on in Signal and they want to extract all this data, what happens, you know, in that process? Well, it turns out this analytics company was just ad hoc, like taking all these files, without any concern for whether there might be malware on these files themselves. And he realized he could literally do anything to these analytics tools machines by just planting the right files within the Signal app. And so, you know, it's really cool what they did. They like had this like clip from hackers, which was kind of cool, kind of showing what they did, which was in the end just putting up a screen that says, "You have been hacked," or something like that. But it's like, it's such a cool piece and it makes me so happy. And then the ending, I think, is my favorite. Ben, I'm going to throw this back to you. What was this completely unrelated news that he was saying at the very end of this piece, which has nothing to do with the article, just unrelated, something that they're thinking of doing in the future?
Sure. So essentially, you know, as this software is like parsing all these files, it has to go through tons of untrustworthy data. And what he kind of hinted at the end there was that Signal might just randomly start putting data packets into the app for no purpose at all, just aesthetics, but with the idea and kind of hinting at that maybe Signal could start screwing with this company, which also previously had announced that it had the capabilities to hack Signal potentially. So this is a little bit of a tit for tat, but also it's just a really funny narrative and kind of an insight into the battles into hackers that are constantly going on behind the screens and security researchers. I mean, quite literally behind the screens of a lot of things that you might use every day.
And I'll also mention, sorry, go ahead, Jen.
No, I was just going to say, I would have loved to see the faces of the people at Cellebrite when this blog post was published. Like, I can only imagine the conversations that are happening there.
Absolutely. Well, this company, so Moxie starts off the piece by talking about some of the bad things they've been involved with. They said that their products have often been linked to the persecution of imprisoned journalists and activists around the world. Their customer lists have included authoritarian regimes in Belarus, Russia, Venezuela, China, death squads in Bangladesh, military juntas in Myanmar, and those seeking to abuse and oppress in Turkey. So, you know, it just seems like it was just such a nice vindication. I enjoyed this piece so much. The fact that they were pushing back. You have lots of analytics firms right now. There's a trend in going into whether it's blockchain data or private messaging or all of this. But it's nice to see these companies standing their ground and saying, okay, if you screw with us, we'll screw with you. And so it's kind of a nice balancing act there.
Yeah. And it also could have downstream implications, right? Like these reports and this kind of like data extraction includes things like location services and other things that have been used in court cases. And so this vulnerability is just now being made public. But the fact of the matter is like this could have been a vulnerability before, and it casts kind of shadows on like information that's been used to indict and put people in prison in a variety of different instances, Naomi, like you kind of alleged to. And I think, you know, we talk about privacy, we talk about security. Those are the really important things to keep in mind, because is a whole micro, or maybe micro, there's a big economy for these kind of services around the world that are kind of just go to the highest bidder. And so that's why we think privacy and these sorts of things are important, and particularly all the cryptographic advances coming from developments in cryptocurrencies more generally.
Yeah, and I will add that the time is quite interesting, right? Because at the start of this month, Cellebrite announced that they're going to be going public via a $2.4 billion SPAC deal. So the fact that Moxie has kind of put them into the limelight, and a lot of people are talking about all of the security holes in Cellebrite software. Like Moxie was pointing out that there were some things they hadn't updated since 2012, yet there had been hundreds of updates released since then. That seems downright negligent for anyone who's using these services to extract information. That would put, you know, people at a lot of in a lot of danger there. So I hope that it kind of sheds some light on the shady things associated with this company.
Well, yeah, timed by Moxie.
Jump in here, get the last word.
I was just going to say, well timed to head the SPAC deal. Also, I feel like just last week we were talking about Moxie and how shady Signal like was with mobile coin, and now
shady. We love mobile coin.
So much credibility.
There's a whole lot going on there.
Yeah.
There's more to this. People got to stop hating on it.